Oh, it is 3 o'clock on the East Coast. I am Justin Guarini. If you don't know who I am, I'm from the first season of American Idol, and I am live here on American Idol. I'm just checking out the page to make sure that we are good to go. Hey, if you are watching this video right now, let me know if you're watching it live or if you're coming in on a replay. I also would love to know where it is that you are coming from. Here we go. Let's see. I got one person in the room here. 21 people joining us. Hello, 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 and welcome to Audition Secrets Live, presented by American Idol. Again, I'm Justin Guarini. I'm looking at the comments here. I'm going to check on my phone, make sure that we are all good to go here. I can't see it on my phone, but that's fine. Hey, it's all good. Hello, let's see. Wow. Susan, hello, how are you? Buford Ryan, how you doing? Christy, hello. Jose Michael, how are you? Welcome, welcome. Rosa Vargas, how you doing? Okay, so we got some people in here. All right, well, thank you again for joining me. This is Audition Secrets Live, presented by American Idol. And basically what I'm gonna do today is I'm here to talk to you about a few audition tips as well as do a Q&A, okay? So, oh, look, see, we got people from Florida, Brazil. Clayton Oliveria, hello, woo, Brazil, obrigado. Hey, so let's start at the beginning. While people are coming in, thank you again for joining me. I auditioned quite some time ago for American Idol, but what's really interesting, and by the way, if you would like to audition for American Idol, let's talk about that. Make sure that you go to AmericanIdol.com/auditions, AmericanIdol.com/audition to find out everything you need to know about auditioning for American Idol. The auditions are happening right now as we speak. They're going to go on at least to the end of September. You can find out where you can audition. You can show up live. And now the most awesome thing is that the excuse of, well, you know, I got to work, I can't show up live, or my cousin's uncle's father's son's best friend's pet lemur has throat cancer and I can't, no. All that doesn't matter anymore because now you can audition online. So all you need to do is go to AmericanIdol.com/audition or auditions, I'm not quite sure, and you will find out everything you need to know there. Okay, so let's get to it. We're going to be here for about 10, 15 minutes or so. I'm going to do a little bit of training, give you some tips on auditioning so that when you show up on the day of, you are absolutely 100% prepared. And then I'm going to open up the floor for a Q&A. Okay? Sound good? Uba Sheik said, they just woke up. All right. Well, wake up because we are getting ready to go. Okay. First off, let's talk about one of the biggest challenges I see auditioners having when they audition for American Idol. And it's not necessarily the challenge, but it's something that I want you to remember, okay? Here we go. It goes a little bit like this. Meaningless movement makes your performance mean less. I'm gonna say it again. Meaningless movement makes your performance mean less. Now, what do I mean by that? Well, when you walk up to the line and you're auditioning and you're standing with your people left and right of you, you're going to be asked to step forward and to sing for the judges. And what I often will see, because when American Idol kicked off a couple of weeks ago, I was in New York and I got to sit at one of the judges' table. It was so crazy just being on the other side of the coin, right, that I was on years ago. But what I saw were people moving in ways that were completely distracting from the song. There are people who had good voices. There are people who had great voices. There are people who had a great look, who had all this stuff going for them, but they would put their arms behind their back and do this and, you know, kind of do that and look around and make all these movements that were distracting me and distracting the judges from what was really important, which was telling the story, which was singing and just inviting us into your experience of the music. And so one of the best ways that you can stop making meaningless movement, which makes your performance mean less, is to actually tape yourself, break out this phone, and just videotape, I'm dating myself, tape yourself singing. Now, you know, there's that whole just sing in front of the mirror and no, that makes you really self-conscious. That's not what I'm going after. I'm specifically asking you to tape yourself so that you can see the kind of movements and what it is that you're doing. Because more often than not, people do things that are just don't have anything to do with the song and distract from the wonderful, beautiful performance that you're giving. Okay, so tape yourself and look at the movement and see where you can not move, or on the other side of the coin, see where you can make a little bit more movement, because singing like this isn't great either. Okay, rolling right along. That is Meaningless Movement Makes Your Performance Mean Less. If you're just joining us, I'm Justin Guarini. This is Audition Secrets, live presented by American Idol. I was on season one of American Idol. I've got a whole bunch of really great stuff when it comes to auditions. If you want to find out more about it, all you have to do is go right here to auditionsecrets.com. Mm-hmm, right over there. You can get my book, a free download of my book, Audition Secrets, the behind-the-scenes guide to nailing more auditions and booking more jobs. All there, Audition Secrets, right for free. Okay, we just talked about meaningless movement makes your performance mean less. And now the next point is, when you see it, we'll believe it. Now, all you have to do is go back on YouTube or wherever you find your videos and look at any of the top, whether it's 10, 12, 13, however many it was, depending upon what season you watch. Look at the performers from there. And those seasons, and watch them perform, and watch how none of them just stands there and sings at you. They invite you into their experience. You can see them having fun with the song. You can see what it is, almost what it is that they see in their minds. And that's the whole point of this. When you see it, we'll believe it. So often I see people singing at me. I see singers singing at judges, where it's just like, you know, I'm gonna sing a song and, you know, here are the lyrics and this is just the way it is. Worst country song ever, I know. But do you see the difference, as opposed to I'm gonna sing a song and here are the lyrics and I love it. And I'm having a good time, right? I'm seeing it in my mind. I'm having a great time. And the performances that really stick out are the performances where we get to watch other people enjoying themselves up there, okay? And so one of the best things that you can do in order to help yourself see it a little bit more in your mind is to do something I call the movie in my mind exercise, where you sing a song, and it's better to do this privately first so you can get a real feel for it, and then publicly later, but see the song in your head. And what I mean by that is see the music video, see yourself. If they were to shoot a music video, I don't care if it's a song that's been out, that's been covered by Beyonce or whomever, put yourself in your imagination, in your mind, into the music video. What would you be doing? How would you want it to look? Who would that person or situation be that you're singing to or singing about? And the more that you can get into that and forget about the judges and the audience necessarily and all those things, that's later. But initially, when you can just see it in your mind and create your own experience, the more that you do that, the more that everyone outside will live through your experience and will love it and will have a great time watching you have a great time. Yeah? All right. Okay. Moving right along. Thank you. I'm talking very fast because I want to keep this brief and I want to get to your question. So enough of me yammering. Okay. The final point I'd like to make is tell us your story. That is so very important. American Idol goes to great lengths to find out and to edit and beautifully craft the stories of the people who come on the show. Why? Because this show is about talent, yes, but it is about you. It is not about the judges. It's not about the music necessarily. I mean, yes, all these things are part of it. But one of the things that makes American Idol so wonderful and the reason why it has consistently been at the top of the charts for so long is because it is about you. When we watch American Idol, ooh, it gives me goosebumps just to think about it. But when we watch American Idol, we fall in love with your story. We fall in love with the ups and the downs and everything in between that you go through, right? So why not, as you are auditioning, tell us your story through the music. Yes, you may be singing a song by Adele, or you may be singing a song by Beyonce, or by Lane Hardy, whoever, but it is that story, those lyrics, as told by you, the performer. And it doesn't matter if 100 performers sing Rolling in the Deep by Adele, if you all own your own story, and if you tell your version of Rolling in the Deep, what does that mean to you? Who or what are you singing about? What struggles have you gone through that you can relate to those lyrics? Then each and every single one of those 100 performances will be absolutely unique and different. And that's what we want, folks. That on the other side of the table, the everybody from the executive producers on down to, I don't know, whoever is at the bottom of the rung, all we want is your story, because without you and your story, there is no show. Okay? All right. Now that I have done some yammering, I am going to open it up a little bit to a nice Q&A. All right, we're about 11 minutes in here. And so if you have some questions for me, please go ahead and ask them now. In the meantime, I'm just going to plug myself while I'm waiting for your questions here. If you want to find out more about what it is that I do, private coaching, my book, my podcast, all by the name of boop, Audition Secrets, all you have to do is go whoop, right over here. It's hard. I always want to point this way. All you do is right over here to whoop, auditionsecrets.com, and you can find out all about that. Okay, so let's look at some of the comments here and see what everyone has to say. Let's see. Laura Seymour says, I used to do karaoke in Denver. Well, congratulations. I think that's all. Oh, Betsy. Betsy, dear, look, you missed the long hair. Don't you worry about a thing. I'm very, very tempted to just grow it out again. And I may do that just for you. Okay, so if there are any more questions, let's see. Here's a funny one that is well above my pay grade. How much money goes into American Idol? How much time you got? Quite a bit, but most of it goes to making an amazing experience for you. Okay, so again, here we go. This is questions. I'm going to look back through some of the comments. Let's see. Oh, American Idol. Hey, I love you too. Thank you very much. Wow, let's see. Lisa ACM, hello from Brazil. Living in Romania that speaks Italian. Oh my goodness, you just took me on a world tour right there. All right. Here we go. So we don't have any questions so far. I'm going through some comments. Let's see. Oh, American Idol Spain is coming soon. Idol Kids, love it, love it, love it. Well, look, I'm trying to tell you. Let's see. Here we go. Tips for Chris wants to know tips for getting cut on Hollywood Week, even though you killed it. Well, it's really interesting. When I went out to Hollywood Week, and it hasn't really changed. I mean, the general concept of everything hasn't changed. It's very interesting because there was, at the time, 126 of us. And then the very next day, boom, they cut it in half. And then they cut it in half from there. And even though you get cut on Hollywood Week, with the way things are now, Eric, it's super important to remember that you got to Hollywood Week. You got right there. I can tell just by your profile picture that you were on the show, and that is gold. Remember that that exposure to millions and millions and millions of people is absolute gold. And people are going to want to follow you. People want to find out more about you. So take every scrap of that video that you can find here on YouTube from your time on American Idol in front of the judges. That's what your picture looks like. Take every scrap of video that you can find from Hollywood Week and put that up on your socials. And most importantly, keep putting out content. Leverage that. Use the fact that you got onto American Idol and that you got onto TV. And just put out great content. Engage with your fans. Put out more content. Put out your music. And then just continue to grow your audience. All right? There you go. Congratulations for getting to Hollywood Week. There are so many people who don't. And also, there are so many people who make it to Hollywood Week and get cut and then get to audition next year and get to come back. And because they have put in the work on Hollywood Week and the judges got to know them and the people in charge who make all the decisions as well, all the other decisions got to know them, that it was easier for them to get back to Hollywood Week again. And they learned from it. George Washington, George Washington back from the dead, wants to know what was the most difficult part of my audition. You know, the most difficult part of my audition was actually nerves. I was good for the beginning rounds, but then, and it was like literally like something out of like The Gladiator, right? This huge iron door in this big sort of industrial, like, photography zone space in New York, slides back. I walk in, and there I see two people I don't know. One of them's named Simon. Another one is named Randy. And then I see one person I definitely know, forever my girl and yours, Paula Abdul. And I was just, I was shaking. If you go back on YouTube and look at Justin Guarini's audition, American Idol audition, you can see I was wearing this jacket. I had to zip the size of Texas on my face. I was so nervous that I put my hand up at one point when I was singing and I had to put it back down really quickly because I was super, super nervous. But there is something that I have for you when it comes to nerves. And it's called the square breathing exercise. And all you need to do is go to www.iliveToPerform.com/square breathing. And I have this exercise, which I still use today. Because yes, I still get nervous today. I'll be afraid when I don't get nervous, right? I'll be super nervous when I don't get nervous. But all you need to do is go right there, iliveToPerform.com/square breathing. And you can get a free download of the exercise that I use to completely calm myself down, focus, be in the moment, and change my nerves from these things that jangle me and stop me to the excitement, the power, and the passion that I need in order to tell my story. Thank you so very much, Mr. Washington, Mr. President, for your question. Okay, I'm going to take one, two more questions, and then we are going to wrap things up. This is a very interesting question. Maya Pan Miller says, were you confident that you were going to win? You know, no. I mean, I can't imagine anybody who would go up against Kelly Clarkson and be confident that they were going to win. But our mindsets were kind of interesting at the time because we were extremely tired when we got down to the finale. If you think about it, if there was the top 10, like there was my year, there's 10 people that can do all the work, they can do all the commercials, they can do all the interviews, they can do all the everything that you need to do in order to promote this wonderful show and be on it. But then as the numbers lessen, there are less and less people to do the same amount, if not more work. So Kelly and I were just like, oh, at one point towards the end, because we were flying back and forth to New York and doing morning shows, and we did the MTV Music Awards, and it was you know, the promotion that comes, and thank goodness, right? But I didn't really think about winning so much as opposed to just surviving. So that was what I really wanted to do. Okay, let's see. Let's see. I'm looking for some more questions here. Who are the judges going to be for the next season of American Idol? You mean this season upcoming of American Idol? The same judges from last year. Lana, Luke, and Katie. And I'm excited. How could I get a golden ticket? That's a really good question. I actually don't have an answer for that question. Although I think if you audition online, perhaps, I'm sorry, yeah, that might be a way to get it. That's actually something I should come back. I should probably read the questions more before I actually put it up there. Let's see. How could I get a golden ticket? That's another one. That's right. Ah, of course, from straight from the horse's mouth. Don't forget to go to AmericanIdol.com/audition. Auditions, that's right, auditions plural, to audition and register for an open call city and get all of the details. That's right. You got to go there because they have all the forms that you need to fill out and everything where you can tell your story right then and there. You can also audition online. You can see where you can audition, what cities that are close to you and the dates that it's happening. Make sure you go to AmericanIdol.com/auditions to find out. Okay, I'm going to take a few more questions here. Let's see. Trish says, my friend tried out last season and got cut right at the last second, I'm assuming, last season. He got asked to come back. Will that give you a better chance of getting on the show? I don't know if it will give you a better chance of getting on the show. I just think that if you go through, no matter how many rounds you go through, especially if you get deep like your friend did, keep your eyes and your ears open because there's so much that you're going to learn that the next time around, you're going to be able to use to hopefully get that much further. And that deals with song selection. Maybe it was, you know, how you were sounding, how you were performing, whether you were doing some meaningless movement like we talked about earlier, and all the like. So I can't tell you that it would give you a better chance, but the further you get, the more the folks at American Idol get to know you, and the more you have the opportunity to learn as much as you can. So if you need to come back, then if you get the chance to come back because you're a cut, then you'll be that much more prepared. Okay, Maya Pan Miller asked again, were you intimidated by other contestants? And that is a great question to end on. Of course, yeah, I was at the time, without a doubt, because there are people who, I mean, showed up in the most elaborate outfits. There were people who showed up and they sounded amazing. And I don't care if it was a man, woman, child. I mean, the people who showed up who were so, so fantastic definitely did intimidate me. But it was because I did not realize one crucial thing. And it's something that I wish I could tell every person who auditions. If you own your own story, come in and sing your song, even if it's written by somebody else or sung by somebody else, if you come in owning your own story, singing your own song, then there is no competition. I'm gonna say it again. If you own your story, if you come in and you sing your song, and if you deliver your unique performance that is unique to you, then there is no competition because no one else has lived your life. No one else has experienced the things you experienced. No one else can see the world from your perspective. No one else feels things exactly the way you feel things. No one else's voice is exactly like your voice. And if you can truly own that, and if you can come into the audition situation knowing that it's not so much a performance and a, oh, I've got something to prove, but just a showing and a telling and an unveiling of that, of yourself, of that which is unique to you, then there is no competition. No one else can come and deliver your performance. No one else can come and tell your story. No one else can be you. And that's it. That's all I got for you folks. Okay, like I said, let me go back to it here. Do not forget, ladies and gentlemen, to go to AmericanIdol.com/auditions to audition, register for an open call city, and get all the details you need to potentially become the next American Idol. Thank you so very much for watching this live. Thank you so very much for watching the replay. I am Justin Guarini. This has been Audition Secrets Live, presented by American Idol. If you would like to find out more about what it is that I do, all you need to do is go right over there to get my free book or just to see what it is I'm up to. I got a podcast. I got a whole bunch of the things at auditionsecrets.com. In the meantime, I will see you when I see you, and good luck to everyone auditioning for American Idol.